broadcast live.
Does the success or the well-being of the album, does that literally kind of answer back to your bookings as a DJ? Does it reflect on your DJ bookings when the album does well?
Yeah, so when I was producing the album, because I was distant from social media and just the party scene, and I had to really draw back to sort of listen to myself, to hear your own thoughts, because when you're in the club every week, you don't hear your own thoughts, you just hear the common music playing in the club. If you're watching a lot of TV, you're gonna replay whatever you
watch.
You know, so I had to really draw back for the sake of the music, and I think the bookings declined in that period. I wasn't like down and out, but it was a decline. Now the album out, there's no calls I'm making. The calls just, you know, coming this way.
Okay.
Which is, you know, what I want.
I must book you when things are down, man. And the prices are low, you know, when you're humble. So yeah, dura, man. Not bad. So basically you took that sacrifice to literally just like, oh, listen, I want to get my head in this album. You took the sacrifice to miss, to not do gigs. Obviously, out of sight, out of mind. It's the name of the game. So you made, that was, is that like a big sacrifice? It's a gamble. Because how you know if people are going to still want to fuck with you or just say, that guy was from Do Like I Do.
That was the gamble. When I was bringing back this album, I was like, geez, bro, you took, you know, because even in the streets, when you got in the streets, people was like, hey, man, where you been, actually?
Yeah, you know what I mean?
Like, for me, I'm content because I know what I'm doing is going to serve a higher purpose than just being here in the club. You know?
And
when you leave like that, when you come back to the people, you have one chance. You know what I mean? It's like, hey, you've been gone, man. Okay, let's listen. If you're a gag, I can't see.
Yeah.
You know what
I mean?
So they bumped, and I guess, you know, they like what they heard.
Do you, as a DJ, do you practice what you're going to play in your sets, or how do you keep on to what's popping? Because let's say you've been sitting in the studio all this time. Like, do you take another month now after you're done in the studio to kind of go, let me hear what's happening in the market so I know what's...
So the thing is, like, the club plays the same music, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Even if you can come with like the latest song that dropped last night and you're thinking, oh my god, I want to blow the club off today, it's not gonna happen. You know what I mean? So whatever was popping 3 months ago will still be popping 4 months later. All you gotta do is check like Apple charts, check, you know, YouTube charts, just check people's stories, what they're bumping. That's how you sort of get a gist of what's really going on right now. And in terms of like skill and all that, I think I started off playing CDJs normal, you know, and I don't really plan my sets regardless.
Yeah.
You know, I always just look at the crowd, I check the age group, girls, boys, okay, cool, old, young, okay, cool. Probably like this type of music, and I go off of that. Because now if you go into the club with a banging hit after hit set, and then you get to the club, and they say, no, the club only pop off the next 3 hours. And then you, like, 3 hours before the main set, you came with this bang set, and you can't change it now. It's going to look weird playing a bunch of hits with people who are still trying to get into the mood.
So there's club code.
People don't know that, but the real DJ does.
It's club code, isn't it? That up-and-coming guy who's trying to kill. Say, I'm going to come for your spot. And he's playing all the hits. Oh wow, that's crazy. And then also obviously that influences the type of music, so you, the type of music you're making, because do you pick up, when you pick up your album and you go, this one is for the club, from the sound of it, I don't think that's how you plan it, but do you, is there anything right now that on your album you can pick up and say, this one's for the club?
Yeah, there's a couple of drums I can pick up and say, this is for the club. So also when I make music, I check what's missing in my set, me personally. I'll check, okay, I'm in the 80s range, 80 BPM. There's not much South African local hip-hop in the 80s, and the 80s is banging, you know? It's like, praise the Lord, there's this, you know, and like, in the States, in that region, it's banging, but this side's not banging. So when I create in the studio, I make sure that, okay, cool, let's fill this gap, let's fill this gap. So like, please, Fresh Chick, Exit Plan, to some extent, Your Dick, Sanana, Spansam, those are like my club bands. Those are in my set right now.
Yeah.
I won't pass it because I know that I needed it to cross over to another EP.
Okay. That's some incredible shit. It's like one healthy. You just opened the DJ school. Like, need to work with Zintle. So, now that this album is done, it's like, I mean, I've always felt that DJ is literally like, I feel some of them don't take it seriously, you know, with the regards to the quality of the songs. But with other DJs dropping albums, what do you think the competition is like anyway? Do DJs really take this thing seriously? You know, is it just because I got the power to do it?
For me, sometimes I feel like, let me speak for myself. For me, it's not for the club. There's people who will meet me in whatever country I'm in, right? And once they realize who I am, they light up, get excited. But for me, that excites me because it's like, yo, you actually bump my music. You know my music, you took the time to my face. I'm not on TV, I'm not on radio, but I'm still ass. You know what I mean? And I don't do it for the club, I don't do it for people to, you know. For me, I literally do it to fill gaps in hip hop, because I feel like there's just so many gaps in hip hop that we need to physically fill. There's not enough content, and there's not enough music out there. And I feel like as us DJs pushing, I mean, a few years back, DJs would push local content fully. In the era of Soda Market, fully push music, you know, and it comes as a force. If all the DJs who are playing in the music scene are pushing, you know, a local sort of movement. But I mean, if we now crumbling and falling to the side, just playing whatever just to please the crowd, that means you're playing for the club.
Well, that's the question I want to ask though. Where is that support gone with DJs? Why aren't DJs playing like local stuff like they used to, you know? At least even when they weren't playing it around the time, they tell you, no, we need it like this or in this format. Where you got guys like Double D who are creating DJ mixes every week, one would think that, yo, and he's literally sampling all the DJs. One would think that people are getting it and they should be playing it and trying to push these songs, mixing them with what's popular and throwing them in, you know? What's the barrier? Because a bunch of y'all are making songs already, you know, DJs. Are you guys now competing with each other, to be quite honestly, that like y'all aren't playing each other's joints? Because it would be understandable when you used to work with artists and you remember all the time you had the Sori Marquez, all those On My Own, all those songs were DJ songs. They weren't artist songs. So I don't know whether the DJs are now competing with each other, because the DJs seeded hip hop. So even if Casper came through On My Own, or Young and Story Make, or whoever, literally when the guys came through, then they would jump on and do their stuff because that DJ song has popped and is in the club or whatever the case be, you know? So I don't know what's happening with y'all niggas.
To be WhatsApp group I also don't know. I think this thing of clout becoming the currency, clout's the new currency. And I feel like people are taking things too personal, man. You know? It's like, I don't have to be beer buddies with you for you to play my song. You know what I mean? You don't have to be beer buddies with me for me to play your song. If your song's hard, I'm playing it.
How about these guys you're playing songs of? I was no guys.
You know what I mean?
From the world.
So I'm out there playing other guys' songs, you know what I mean? I'd expect them to do the same, but in reality, it's not like that. But there's nothing you can do about it either.
Sure. I mean, the DJs, I think, are missing the importance, you know. And it's not a diss to them, but it's more like an awareness to the of the power, you know.
Yeah.
The DJs literally have always been the foundation of, even if it's through their own songs, have always been the foundation of, like, then they shoot the video push, then the artist literally leverages on that and they jump, you know. But I think people also feel like, yo, you started here, and then artists become, people start becoming too personal with these things and take things very, like,
this is the game. There's need time for personal stuff.
Yeah, you owe me this, or I started this, so remember, now he's like this. Oh, now he, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's too much of that.
Weird
in the
times,
game.
Weird times, bro. Weird times. And, like, we can preach about it, but the thing is, it's literally not going to change.
And Nkuluma and Nkule group, I'm a DJ or WhatsApp.
Someone will drop a song or whatever, put a pack in the group. Someone will say, yo, that's hot. One person will say that's hot, and everyone else just read and continue with their lives. But if Travis Scott dropped, they're playing it.
So you guys are your own enemy.
Dude, it's weird, bro. That's why
I mean, I know they talk about the rappers, but the rappers literally only have power when they are saying the words on the mic.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The rappers are not the power of distribution. The DJs are the power of, like, spreading the message.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So I know people put a lot of weight on the artist, like, yeah, but the artist, which, like, the artist also needs to be accountable, needs to be respectful, and needs to also acknowledge the place of the DJ. But even if they don't, the DJ's job is to be distributing.
Yeah.
Whether you, because Travis Scott is not about to give them a shout.
No, not at all. But I mean, if, let's say, Younger's, like, before even Younger dropped 200, I dropped it in a radio mix on, what was it on? I think it was on 5FM. I dropped it already, you know, because it's hot. It's a nice song. It goes in with my songs.
Yeah.
So people are missing that point. Like, if something is hot and it goes along with your songs, play it. It's got a little bit of a knack. You'll connect with people, you know? And it doesn't hurt you to play this. Even if someone doesn't know it, you're teaching someone. What happened to teaching people? People will say, yeah, but we're not doing it anymore.
And you get these, sorry to cut you, and you get these DJs who are on radio, who get sets on radio, who also have the opportunity, who, like, there's an audience of a million and you've got a mix. Every opportunity of doing commercial and throwing that other joint. I think a lot of the DJs that I've heard, and I don't listen to much radio, when they are throwing local joints, they're throwing, like, old joints. You know what I mean?
I guess they kind of saying that nothing's popping right now, and it's like, open your ears, man.
There's a lot of things happening.
There's a lot of things happening. There's a lot of things happening right now. My mixes lately are quite fun because there's a lot of new local content that I've slotted in. You know, even if you're playing five, even if you're playing five in the hour, it's enough. Even if you're playing 10, it's enough.
You are the power, you know.
So that's why I sort of do my albums, because I'm trying to bring in collaboration. At my listening session, all the artists who had never met each other were out there taking each other's numbers. And that's dope. For me, that's dope. That's collaboration. You know what I mean? That's all I want to see. All I want to see is collaboration.
Yeah, yeah.
So instead of talking about it, I'm going to do it.
Yeah.
Even next year, I'm going to drop volume three.
Oh, really?
Not because I'm pushing collaboration.
Have you got, like, songs already?
Not yet, because I cook. Shouldn't be too difficult.
Okay. It's a good thing of Indie Fruity Loops, isn't it?
Best thing I ever did for myself.
That's dope, man. That's dope. I mean, NJM Volume 2, I think you gotta let that album breathe before you drop anything else.
Yeah, I'm gonna wait a whole year.
Yeah, I think that's an album for the books. It's got great, really good songs. You have a great mix of now, you have a great mix of then, you have a great mix of hood, you know, and one, it's difficult these days to get one person who can put those things together.
Yeah.
Everybody is either, if they trap, they trap. If they hood, they hood. If they now, they now. Or if they, so, you know, like, that's the problem with the albums. They're very
one-sided
and there's no balance. And I think your album literally spreads everything. You got a base of everything. You know what I mean? And yeah, man, I just want to thank you for the album. Thanks for the music. And most importantly, thanks for filling the gaps. I think that was a key thing that you said. just filling the gaps.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah, no, you can use the name Slick as long as you can continue using it.
Shut up, bro.
DJ Slick. Are you still calling you? Every DJ is dropping DJ. Why are DJs dropping DJ?
I won't lie, my handle has always been Slick.
Yeah.
Just solely because I knew from the jump that I'm way too talented to box myself. I can become this, I can become that, I can become this, I can. So if it's just Slick, you know Slick, the guy.
Yeah.
So what he's doing really doesn't, at the time, really doesn't matter, but you know Slick, the guy.
Yeah. I mean, look, people call me like with your name nowadays. I'm not gonna lie.
I even mean, hey, DJ Sliqe!
Yeah, at least if it's happening to you, it's good. Because it happens to me, I don't even fight it anymore. I'm Sliqe. Yeah. And I'm like, I, you know.
I gave you some life.
Well, I gave you an important name, you know? You know, I gave you legacy. I gave you, let's say, legacy.
I'll take that.
I'll take life. I'll take life. You know, significance.
I'll take that.
DJ Slick, get the album Volume 2. It's out in stores, every streaming platform. It's one of the dopest albums done by a DJ that I've heard this year. So make sure you do yourself a favor and get the damn thing.
Broadcast live.